I'm here with promising recruit Sam Hooper. And Sam, I've really enjoyed your form in recent times. Let's take a look.
Assesses the situation, hangs back from the man in front, showing off his silky smooth foot skills right there. Oh, the kids will love that one. Hooper props, keeps well clear of the boundary. Gee, that was great awareness. This kid's really going places.
And speaking of going places, Sam, any chance for a lift?
Okay.
He's a beauty, this kid.
Speaking of the list manager, Terry Wallace is our list manager here on the program. We like to have a good look at all issues. And today we launch our premiership window for Batoki. Insist on Batoki, of course, with a famous range of hams, bacon and salami. Simply the best. And free agency is about simply the best too, Plough, because it is very important now that clubs maximise their opportunity in this premiership window.
Well, if you want to open up the premiership window, you've got to do free agency right, and we sort of the first look at it last year. But why did it come in the first place? Well, I think it came in first up because of restraint of trade. They didn't want to be going down the pathway of going to the courts. I think a lot of the 7 to 10 year players who weren't in the best group at their clubs were being disrespected with contracts at times, so it needed to come in. Shifty, do you just want to give us a bit of a feel about the eligibility and how that works?
Yeah, just look at what the unrestricted free agents are for a start. So they're guys that have been 8 or more years at the one club, and they're not in the top 25% in terms of salary. So they're not the top 20 or 10 players at their club. And importantly, they're out of contract. Also, they might be those who have played 10 years or more and are out of contract. So they're both those groups of players are unrestricted free agents. And then the restricted free agents are those with 8 years of service and they are in the top 25%. So they're the ones with the restricted free agency.
Well, we got our first opportunity last year to actually be able to have a look at how the free agency would work. I think some clubs were better prepared for it, and I think, Jack, your club was one of those. Knew what they wanted and just went out and got their men.
Yeah, definitely under, obviously, Craig Cameron and Blair Hartley, who does our list management at our football club. They'd sort of signalled or picked out the blokes they wanted to get along from our from other football clubs to help bolster our ranks. Speaking of Chaplin and Knights, we'd sort of done a little bit of free agency without actually being free agency before that in terms of Grigg and Hawley and Ivan Maric. So it's about identifying who you want and who you think can help you improve. And we've obviously gone out there and done that successfully with Chappie this year and a little bit successfully with Knighty. Obviously, he's injured at the moment, but he's one in the future we think can really be a big improver for us.
And there's various ways to look at it as well. I mean, Collingwood Footy Club, for example, people are sort of saying, did they get it right? They brought in Quinton Lynch to the place. Was it actually right? But what they did was they let Wellingham and Lynch go, picked up two first-round draft picks for those two players. And one of those was young Kennedy, Ben Kennedy. The other was Brody Grundy from South Australia. So, you know, we're just having a look at some vision of Lynch. People are sort of saying, oh, were they right in bringing Lynch to the club? Well, we won't know for 5 years because it's how those other boys went. They let two go out through the trade, brought two guys into the club through free agency.
And they'd be happy with Ben Kennedy straight away, wouldn't they? He's played half a dozen games in his first year. Brody Grundy has had injuries, and I think he's played very well at VFL level yesterday, so the jury's still out on that.
Gono was the biggest name to move last year, and he's had a fantastic year at the Essendon Footy Club. Do you, Plough and Shifter, favour compensation? As this, the clubs didn't think it worked last year, did they?
Yeah, look, there's a lot of clubs that are suggesting that there shouldn't be any compensation. What goes around comes around. I'm not quite sure that that's the case. When you have a look, I mean, the success rate's been quite good in its first year. And when I have a look at the jury out players, I mean, most of those are because of injury. I thought Jarrod Rivers was having a wonderful few weeks when he was actually playing in that Geelong side. So I still think there's a little bit of work to be done there. Certainly Goddard was the standout of the players. And
will it change, Shifter? Will there be...
I think they tend to leave things in for a couple of years, certainly under review, but I think it'll stay.
And then when we have a look at who are the key players that we're going to be looking at this year, when you're looking from a restricted point of view, you've got Franklin, obviously, Daisy Thomas, Del Santo up there, and Cooney, the key unrestricted, so that we've just got an idea of what we're looking at. Sylvia Ellis, Matty White, Jason Paul. Pleasure are some players that might be there. Obviously, Jack, the big one is going to be Lance Franklin.
Yeah, look, I suppose Lance Franklin in his own is really an unrestricted free agent in terms of how he can move. We saw with Judd and his move from West Coast to Carlton, and it was really who could match the money to get him along. So look, it's going to be an interesting time for the Hawthorn Football Club, and obviously Lance, when he makes the decision at the end of the year if he's going to stay there or move on to greener pastures.
And he's a restricted, of course, which means it can be matched by the team, but the GWS peculiarity means that it will be tough because of the amount of money. So
exactly. Look, it's a watchy space, yeah, though, this whole area.
That's how it washes itself out. Fascinating. Thanks, Plough. Look forward to that. More of the Premiership window next week.